what you can hear is a quick radio check, which is 1 in 4 elements. Okay, so I'm just going to walk and talk through the concept with you.
So today we're here to proof the concept that regardless of the color of the vehicle, with enough preparation and dedication, we have the ability to camouflage really in any scenario, but specifically here in the forests of Western Poland. So in all honesty, it takes the crew approximately 2 hours to camouflage to the standard that we have here. So we have our basic camo net that we have slightly modified to break up the signature, both of the hardened portions of the turret and the hull itself, also reducing our thermal signature. So that's step one. Step two is going to be to gather foliage generally surrounding the same area in which you're going to occupy a tactical assembly area, an attack position, or an assault position. Use that foliage to continue to modify the edges and help the vehicle itself blend in. As you are adding foliage, you need to ensure that all your systems still work. So your ITAS, your primary gun system, your commander's independent viewer, ensure that the driver's able to drive. And then you just do certain spot checks to ensure once again that the net itself or the foliage is not impeding the movement of the turret or the actual movement of the Bradley itself. So what we're currently in is an assault position, which would be our last covered and concealed position before we move to an objective. Here, we would conduct priorities of work, finalize our plan, and then deploy onward, you know, to an assault, a defense, or whatever it may be. It's really that last covered and concealed position where we could prep for our final execution on the objective. One reason why we did a lot of the preparation in the motor pool, or really in the tactical alpha-alpha, prior to coming out here is throughout our maneuver, we're going to have to occupy several assembly areas or assault positions or attack positions en route to our objective. We need to have the ability to quickly move into a wooded area and not be able to be observed by any potential enemy. So it was important that within approximately 15 minutes, this Bradley was able to go from maneuvering in a large open area directly into the wood line and blend in with the local surroundings. And once again, I can't emphasize enough the ability to maintain the functions of the weapon system and the vehicle itself. Okay, so the easiest thing to do in camouflaging our vehicles in this specific scenario is the amount of foliage that surrounds the area, specifically deadfall, and in the winter it's also made it a little easier. So you're able to collect up that deadfall, the branches that allow you just to look, you know, much like a bush or a tree that's in the woods. When you're camouflaging in, let's just call it the National Training Center in the desert, usually you have to look for berms or a draw, a little bit of dead space. And one thing that you could come into issues with when you're doing that is line of sight communication. So one thing that we're able to do significantly better is hide within the wood line and still maintain that ability to communicate as we're hidden. So fieldcraft is a priority really in anything from a dismounted squad being able to blend in to its surroundings to a Bradley fighting vehicle. So we will emphasize fieldcraft, camouflage, and the ability to blend into your immediate surroundings in every training exercise. So this is really just a proof of concept and the initial training to ensure that we have the ability to do it. From here on out, we're going to continue to better our ability to do exactly that. You know, just having conducted the National Training Center rotation, we were forced to blend in due to the Op 4 and the enemy situation template that was going on the scenario that was presented at the National Training Center. So just now, 3 months ago, we had to do the same thing in the desert with these vehicles. And we did it phenomenally. We had the ability to execute hide sights, alpha-alpha operations, assault positions, and remain undetected from the enemy. To be able to do the same thing in a completely different environment really shows the proficiency of the crew themselves to camouflage their Bradley fighting vehicle, or tank for that matter.
So we've got this as a perfect example right here. We're using this large chunk of tree. It's not actually necessarily covering the Bradley, but it's breaking this line and leading away to dissipate that signature of the vehicle. We've got brush along the side. You can see we're using the natural terrain as well. So we're running this brush down, once again, just to change that signature. Instead of having a blocky vehicle coming up the top, you've got some lines to lead your eye away from the lines of the vehicle. You can see a little better here how we're using this natural foliage to break up the line of that antenna and just to cover the color of the vehicle and create a less of a signature like you were looking at this vehicle. You can see my commander's sight up here is fully operational right now, as well as the gun. Both the 25mm and my coax are both fully functional with the camouflage on it. So our initial steps in our camouflage process involved our camouflage net right here. This is a typical radar scattering and laser scattering net. We just covered the vehicle as best we could, once again using chunks of it to break up the outline, create a visual difference in it. Once we had our camo nets on, we moved out here. We actually collected a lot of natural foliage. Nothing you see here was cut down. This is all deadfalls and material that was already on the forest floor. So back in our tactical alfalfa, we started going ahead and applying a lot of the brush you see on the sides and on the turret, and then bringing some extra stuff that we had just kind of stacked on top for the movement out here. Once we got into place was when we really kind of finished the small details on it. So coming and laying this brush down, coming off the sides, adding in, we actually added snow to mimic the natural environment. So we gathered snow from back behind our fighting position and actually added that in after we were in place here. And then our final step was just to move out away from the vehicle and kind of get an idea of what was popping out in the wood line. One of the things it's real easy to see is like our headlights have a very distinct round signature to them. So we made sure we got those covered after we were in place just so they wouldn't stand out to the eye.